God mean what he say?
Amen.
Amen. He means what he says, saints.
Amen.
Folks today are in garbage. And they think that it's going to, amen, continue. But I'm here. It's going to be a day of reckoning.
Amen.
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 He said, now the works of the flesh are manifest, which are these: adultery, fornication, uncleanness, lasciviousness, idolatry, witchcraft, hatred, variance, emulation, wrath, strife, seditions, heresies, envy. Folks today are envious.
Amen.
Of other folks.
Amen.
Amen. If you're in Christ, you don't have to be envious of nobody. Because you're sealed to the day of redemption.
Amen.
That should be the ultimate victory, the ultimate crown. As long as I'm saved, Lord, that's the main thing. And if I serve you, you're going to take care of my needs, and you might even give me some of my wants.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
So why should you and I be envious?
Amen.
What we are.
Amen.
Even filled with the Holy Ghost. Murders, drunkenness, revelings, and such a like. Amen. Of which I tell you before, as I have also told you in time past, that they which do such things shall not inherit the kingdom of God.
Amen.
It's not coming by according to past thoughts, but it's coming according to they that do such things.
Amen.
You're envious? Forget it.
Amen.
Amen. You're into idolatry? Forget it.
Amen.
Whoremongering? Forget it.
Amen.
I don't care what your title is. Your pastor so-and-so, and you got the women on the side, you ain't gonna make it.
Amen.
I don't care how good you can preach, you can set the church on fire. See, I found out, believe not every spirit.
Amen.
It's so true.
Amen.
Folks can set the church on fire. They're not living nothing.
Amen.
They're not going.
Amen.
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 Amen. It's coming down. Amen. Where the rubber meets the road, saints.
Amen.
Time is winding up.
Amen.
We need to be ready.
Amen.
But the fruit of the Spirit.
Well.
And I found out that it's sorely lacking within the house of God. Is love,
Jesus.
Joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith. Whatever God has for me, he has for me.
Amen.
Amen. And if it's not meant to be, so be it.
Amen.
But I'm going to still go on serving God.
Amen.
That's the way you have to look at it.
Amen.
Amen. Because if you get caught up, amen, you're going to lose out with God.
Amen.
You're going to lose your blessing.
Amen.
Amen. Meekness, temperance, against which there is no law. And they that are Christ have crucified the flesh with the affections and lusts. If we live in the Spirit, let us also walk in the Spirit.
Amen.
Let us not be desirous of vainglory, provoking one another, envying one another.
Amen.
Amen. Somebody got a bigger hat on than you, you get upset. What's she trying to prove? All you mean is she have a bigger hat on than you. It doesn't mean that the Lord loves her for.
That's right.
It doesn't mean that she's better than you.
Amen.
If they drive a newer car than you do, it doesn't mean that God loves you any less.
Amen.
Or God favors you any less. Believe it or not, it doesn't mean that.
That's
all the time. Because like I said, I look at it like this. This is just my opinion. The best car is the one that takes you to and from wherever you go. And at the end of the month, there's not a letter. Amen. With a bill. Amen. I found out that when I get back in that car, it seems to drive better.
Well,
because there's not a bill that goes along with it.
Well.
Sometimes we have to have a car with a bill. Because not every one of us is a shade tree mechanic.
That's right.
You gotta use wisdom.
Amen.
Not every one of us can stand out there in the middle of 40 or 85 at 12 o'clock at night.
That's
and
right.
Get under the hood.
Right.
Especially if we're women.
Well,
me and men, I don't wanna do that. And I'm a man.
Amen.
I don't wanna do that.
Amen.
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 Not all of us can do so. You got to use wisdom. But it does not mean that they are better than you.
Amen.
God is no respecter of persons.
That's right.
In fact, that should encourage you. because that is, that's what you desire. You tell the Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
But one of the things, amen, Bishop Brown, he was wise. See, because, amen, he understood what people were going through. And because he had experience in life, even though I didn't, I was looking at the situation, Lord, what am I going to do?
That's true.
The walls are going to cave in. Oh, God, I don't know what I'm going to do. The walls are caving in, and I'm not going to make it through this. Hold on, son.
Amen.
God got your back.
Amen.
You're going to make it.
Amen.
And when he started talking about his life, all of a sudden, gave me some confidence.
Amen.
I can make it. I can do this. And that's how he kept the people going.
Amen.
And then when the Lord came in and the Lord blessed them, they said, wow, the man of God was right. They said, really? I wasn't just saying it for lip service. Amen. Because you think about it. He started out with just him and his family.
Amen.
There was no church in Greensboro. There was no church in Richmond. No church in New York. No church. It could only have been done by the grace,
amen,
and the power of God.
Amen.
And started and laid a good, a solid foundation.
Amen.
Shame on us when we pervert what God has given us.
Amen.
Shame on us. Ain't no problem with God. Jesus hasn't changed. He is the great I am. That means he's perennial.
Amen.
See, you may be up and down one day to the other, but God is always the same. That's why I say I'm a great I am. I was here before. I'm here now. I'll be here after. And I'll be here after.
Amen.
The great I am.
Amen.
He don't change. Amen. And it goes on to say in the 6th chapter, amen, in the, I'm going to start off at the 4th verse. Let every man prove his own work, and then shall he have rejoicing in himself alone and not in another. Let every man bear his own burden. You got to prove yourself.
Amen.
Amen. Ain't no magic carpet ride. You see, some folks, what they're doing now, they're going along, they're hitchhikers, as Bishop Brown used to say. They're going along with the crowd. And you might see some of them. And you might ask, Lord, why? It's not to worry about that. God said, let the wheat and the tares grow together.
Amen.
And in the end, I'm going to do the sifting.
Amen.
See, sometimes God is doing some pre-sifting now.
Uh-huh.
But there's some folks that are strong, that are bold. There's certain things that I would not do.
Amen.
And stay, amen, up here.
Amen.
Well, I would have to say, you know what? I'm a bum, that's what I am. Now let me go out and die and go to hell. Or until I'm willing to get right, amen, you're going to have to find somebody else. Amen. Because I would be kind of afraid, amen, that God might get me.
Amen.
I told you before, amen, I used to be afraid of getting upset with the man of God. I got upset with him, but I'd be fearful.
Amen.
I said, God might take my life if I hold an order against the man of God.
Amen.
Some folks with the, I didn't even have the Holy Ghost then. Some folks with the Holy Ghost, they got no problem,
amen,
having an order with the man of God or anybody else in the church. They got no problem with it.
Amen.
And they can shout,
amen,
just as much as you. They can praise the Lord. They take communion. They can do all these things. But their heart ain't right.
Amen.
What did Jesus say? We said all the time, and the rest will I set it off.
Amen.
When I come back.
Amen.
See, there's a day of reckoning coming.
Amen.
See, you gotta read the word of God. It's a consistent thing. There's a day of reckoning coming.
Amen.
It is a pattern. God works with a divine pattern of things. Amen.
Amen.
And you got to recognize it so you won't be caught unawares. Some of us, we've been warned and warned, and we're still going to be caught unawares. Why? Because we did not heed or hearken or listen.
Amen.
When it was spoken, when it was told, when we were warned. And he goes,
Let him that is taught in the word communicate unto him that teacheth in all good things. And I like this part. It says, be ye not deceived.
Jesus.
God is not mocked. And I want whatsoever a man sow, that shall he also reap.
Amen.
So when it looks as though folks are getting away, they're getting by.
Yes.
Not so.
Amen.
What a man sowed, he gonna reap, saints.
Amen.
Man, woman, young person, don't matter. If you're doing dirt, hey, you're going to reap dirty.
Amen.
If you're teaching disobedience, you're going to reap disobedience.
Amen.
If you're sowing unto the flesh, you're going to reap corruption.
Amen.
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 And it says, for he that sow unto the flesh shall of the flesh reap corruption. But he that sow to the Spirit shall of the Spirit reap life everlasting.
Yes,
and let us not be weary in well doing, for in due season we shall reap if we faint not. Now closing.
Sometimes it looks like things aren't working out. Sometimes it looks like the unrighteous are getting by.
That's true.
Sometimes it looks like, Lord, it don't seem like, amen. I'll say to somebody, I say it really don't pay to try to correct folks on the job no more. Because there's no authority on our job. Everyone wants to be so relative, so non-committal, so politically correct. They don't no longer